Well, hello and welcome to Kimber Bushcraft. And as you can see, I'm in a camp today. I have two small projects I'm going to do. The first and the most important is this fire reflector at my fire pit. I will remove this and build a small one with these rocks or stones. It's actually quite a task because I have to carry them up in these buckets uphill, and they weigh many kilos. So I'm sweating, yes, that's right. And beside that, I have another project I would like to try if I can make it today. I'm actually going to build some kind of chair. And beside that, a little extra for you. I have made this pouch out of only one piece of leather, and there's no stitching in it. I made a tutorial how to do it. I'm going to show that later, but I'll also tell you in detail about this little pouch. So I hope you hang on and hope you enjoy. Thank you for watching Kimber Bushcraft. It's beginning. Yeah, it's a difficult task to get the stone placed in the right position. Yeah, now I'm finished for now. I won't promise I will make some changes, but this is kind of the way I wanted it to be. It's very difficult with these stones because they don't fit properly all the time, so it's like a puzzle making that. But now I can make my fire there, and a benefit more about this is when I'm making my videos out here, I can film from that direction and have the fire in the foreground and me in the background. So I hope it will be good. The stones are a little bit dirty because these stones I found the farmer had just pulled them up from the ground, so they are very dirty, and I haven't got enough water with me so I can clean them up. So hope it'll rain. And then I got this big stone. It's very flat, and I thought of putting it in the background, but it looks like a tombstone. I don't like that, so I bury it here so I can use it when I prepare my meals. If it's going to be clean, I can use it as a big cutting board, perhaps. I don't know. But it's good to have something there I can put my pots and pans over. So, yeah. But this is it. And now for the next project before I make my coffee. Yeah, and some of you have already guessed what it is I'm doing. And this ground cloth from P&W Bushcraft that I have had for some years now can do a lot of things. But one thing I haven't tried it with this ground cloth is making a chair out of it. So this is what I'm beginning to make now. I haven't done it before, so I don't know about the height, but I guess this is okay. And then I have to find a stick that can get through this, which actually has, I don't know what it's called in English, but you can stick a stick in here, and they are going to lay it on this one. So now I'm going to find a suitable size and begin to put it up. Little fork there. That's better. It's very nice to sit on. Some small adjustments. Wow, look at this. Doesn't it look like a king's chair or something? I think it's so cool. Now I will sit here. Have my coffee and relax, just relax, enjoying to be out here and actually sitting quite well with my water in reach. As you can see, I'm sweating very much, so I have to drink a lot. Oh, nice. So now, now for the coffee. That's
Well, I promised you that I would tell you a little bit about this little pouch bag. And open it here and sit it down there. I think it's a cool little bag. I haven't decided what I will use it for. Perhaps it's coming on my rucksack. It could be something I had around my neck, an additional pouch to my belt kit. I don't know. But the reason why I made this was because I saw a video on YouTube, Dark Horse Workshop, I think it's called, and he made a little bag, a little bit larger than this one, and with the strap you can have around your shoulders. And well, I think it's a cool little thing because there's no stitching. It is all done with a piece of leather strap that you kind of wave into this material, into this little pouch, and that way the pouch is complete. I made a tutorial, DIY, so you can see how I made this. This one is a little bit smaller than the one he's showing in his video, and I think the leather is a little bit heavier because it's very hard to get these straps into the holes here. But I succeeded, and I put a little antler up here. I think it suits it nicely. So, and down here I have assembled it here with a little pearl, a little glass pearl made on the Viking Museum in Roskilde, like the Vikings did, and of course this. So now I'll show you how I made this. I hope you like. Hang on.
Thank you.
Yeah, I've decided to try to make a little change for my king chair. This one is moving up and down, you can see here. It's removing the bark. So that I'm going to do is drill a hole here and a wood peg in, so that this one will stay in the same position all the time, I think. And that way I'll have a better chair to sit on. Yeah, and I made a little new pouch for my augers to have them in the same place. And I actually bought a Tuneu, these two, from a man here in Denmark. If I remember it, I'll put a link below, but I don't think he's selling for abroad Denmark. Anyhow, a 12 centimeters or millimeters, and I think it's 7 or 8 millimeters, this one. I'm gonna use this on my chair. And first of all, I have to measure it, how high up I want the wood peg. And I think this is a good way up, I think. So around here, a little bit higher. These new augers, they are really cool, very sharp. Yeah, and I found some oak for the wood pegs. That was one. Go and hold it there, so it don't slide down. Now we'll see if it holds. I hope so. Better, but I think it's too high. Perhaps if I take these a little bit more apart. Yeah. Now we're talking. Very relaxing, but perhaps still a little bit too high. I don't know. I can have my shoulders here. I have to think about it, and next time I'll see if I want to adjust it a little bit. It's actually okay to sit here. And when the winter comes, I don't have to sit on the ground, and that's nice, because the ground will be cold. So in this way I'll sit a little bit high up and a little bit warmer. Yeah, cool chair, I think. A chair for a king. Yeah, not that I'm a king, but it looks like a Viking king chair, I think.
Well, folks, this is all for now. Thank you for watching Kimber Bushcraft. I hope you liked this little video and my tutorial of the awesome little pouch I made. Perhaps you can be inspired to make one too, download the templates and just do it. It's nothing to it. And I hope you're having a nice week, and I hope to see you again on the next one. Bye bye and take care.